you a chihuahua. I'm a Rottweiler. I can't believe it. It's so amazing. I can't believe it. This beat is banging. I can't believe it. It's so amazing. I can't believe it. I can't believe it. Hey, check it out.
Check it out.
Check it out.
Yeah, what up? Today is January 2nd, 2015, and it is the second day of the new year. And the first song you heard today was Check It Out by Will.i.am featuring Nicki Minaj. What's up, MA family? Continuing on from yesterday, Happy New Year! I hope you all have a blessed, amazing 2015. I'm B.I.G.'s Benji here filling in for Aaron on Music Access. Now, I've been here filling in for Aaron since this Monday, and it's only been 5 days, but we sent away 2014 and greeted in 2015. This has got to mean something, right? I really believe that there's something special between us. You know, do you? Do you? All right. So, we talked about our New Year's wishes and dreams yesterday, but I got to wondering how you guys spent the remaining New Year's Day. What did I do? Essentially, I just practiced. You know, as usual, it's mostly practice. I'm a new idol, so, you know, I gotta focus on getting my skills up to par. So, in order to prepare for our comeback coming up soon, hopefully, early on this year. Alright, so let me know what you guys were up to on New Year's Day as well. If you leave me your messages, I'll introduce them during message time in just a bit. Alright, let me tell you what's up for today. For the first hour, is there a bad habit or a bad memory that you want to get rid of? You can let me know and we can throw that all away into our MA trash can. And what kind of music quiz will we be solving today? You'll find out on All About Music Quiz. Meanwhile, in the second hour, we have Crazy No joining us for our Friday Corner Dancing in the Club MA. This week's topic is things I've never done before in my life. Think about some things that you've wanted to try but were never able to do before and share it with us. Just write Club MA on your title before sending your messages to us. Here's how you can listen and participate. You can download the Arirang Radio or TuneIn Radio application on your smartphone, and you can also send us messages through the app using the comment function. You can also listen to us by visiting our website www.arirangradio.com/musicaccess and leave your messages there on our message board. You can also see our broadcast in real time. If you're listening, I just did something funny on real time camera. Another way you can tune in is through terrestrial DMB, but this is only available for our listeners living on Jeju Island. The frequencies are 88.7 for Jeju City, 88.1 for Seogwipo, and 101.9 for the Taejong area. You all have been sending in some great song requests, so keep them coming by posting up a message on our message board under the title Request. Alright, we'll come right back after a song for message time. The song is Lucky Strike by Maroon 5. It was Lucky Strike by Maroon 5. I'm special DJ for Music Access, B.I.G.'s Benji, and it's time to listen to your stories with Message Time. Alright, our first message comes from Aura from Canada. She writes, Hello Benji, I am a new fan of you. I think you are so cute and very talented. How you play the violin is amazing. I hope you have a good 2015 and much success for you and your members. Love from Canada. Canada. Love. To Canada. Thank you for your message. You know, violin, like I said, I've been playing it since I was little, so hopefully anytime that I get a chance to bring it out here or play it for you, I can. All right, thanks for your message. Our next message comes from Mara from the USA. It says, Hello, hello, getting ready to sleep. It was such a nice day today. It was actually sunny in Seattle today that I went hiking. I'm tired, so I might go to sleep a little early, so I'll probably fall asleep to Music Access. How was your day today? Do you miss anything about Seattle? My day today, you know, the weather in Seoul is really nice. There's, like, not a cloud in the sky. Do I miss anything about Seattle? I miss my home, I guess. You know, I miss my home. I miss my parents. I miss my home food. Oh, man, our home food is so good. I bet you're jealous because you'll never get to eat something. No, I'm just kidding. But, you know, the way I used to cook at home as well. So I think it's kind of that Seattle mood that I really miss. But I hope that you can fall asleep to the sounds of my soothing voice on Music Access. All right, thank you for your message. Our next message comes from Alejandra Martinez from Mexico. And it says, hi, Benji. I'm Alejandra. How are you? I'm good. I have a question. What is your hidden talent that you have? Greetings to all other members of your group. Kisses. These crazy. Haha, te quiero. What is my hidden talent that I have? Well, I can like double joint certain fingers. I can sort of play other instruments. Oh, here's something that you can hear on the radio that I've shown before, but it's a little something. I can beatbox a little bit. Yo, yo, check it. Yo, hip hop. 1, 2, 3. Wow, I love the way you played Winter. Winter is my favorite of Vivaldi's four seasons. I became speechless when I realized how versatile and talented you are. Needless to say, I am now a big fan of you. 응원할게요, 화이팅. I am glad you are guest DJing. I look forward to the next week. Aw, thank you. For those of you who don't know, I was on a program recently where I was given the opportunity to perform a movement of Vivaldi's Winter solo. Which, you know, if you look it up, you can probably find it. But thank you for listening. All right. Thanks so much to everyone for sending in your messages to Message Time. And now let's listen to a song before we come back with MA Trash Can. The song is Domino by Jesse J. Things you want to delete, memories you want to erase, you can throw them all away here at MA Trash Can. A bad habit I developed recently, a pimple that popped up last night. Ugh, I want to get rid of it now. A slip of the tongue, a mistake I made at work or school. Ugh, erase it from my memory now. If you have things that you want to get rid of or memories that you want to erase from your mind, you can do that here on MA Trash Can. We'll delete those ugly memories and events for you. The reason we have this corner is because after we talk about these mistakes and blunders that we want to erase from our memories, we'll realize, hey, I'm not the only one making mistakes in this world. Other people are suffering from the same thing. Don't you think that'll provide some comfort and relief for us? So, let's take a look at what kind of trash we have today. And our first trash comes from Kai de Guzman from the Philippines. And it says, the time when my friend forced me to handshake with my crush. I was very stunned and I just looked at my crush in shock. He just laughed a bit and took my hand for a handshake. I probably looked horrible as I was really flustered and didn't know what to do. It was really embarrassing. Why is it so hard to act normal in front of your crush? Have you ever had a similar experience? Do you even know what I'm talking about? I want to erase it from my memory. Ooh, well, you know, when I was in elementary school or junior high, you know, we had the crushes and, you know, I know this exact feeling. If I reflect to it as I am now, before I debuted as a trainee, there were times when I would meet, you know, they call it 선배 in Korea. So someone who has already debuted before me. And so when I'd go to meet them, you know, I'd have to shake their hand. But if it's a celebrity that I've known before for a long time, I would get very nervous and very flustered, exactly like you. And, you know, for me, I'd have to put on a certain face because you have to be professional about it and shake it. You know, it's a little different than a crush. But the way that I kind of deal with it is I try to act cool. Like, even if, for example, you have this crush and you had a handshake, you got to play it cool because you got to be that cool girl. So, you know, when he shakes the hand, he doesn't think, oh, she looks a little bit flustered. You know, he may not have even known. So, you know, you don't have to worry about that. But you shake his hand, he's like, oh, this girl's so cool. But, you know, in terms of acting normal in front of a crush, it's always hard. It's something that I think you'll get used to over time. And then you'll figure out how to get, you know, the poker face. But you know what? Don't worry about it, Kai, because we got your back. We're going to delete your memory on three. Are you ready? 1, 2, 3, delete. All right. See that? That memory is gone. I have no idea what you were just talking about because it is gone, gone, gone. All right, now that that's erased from your memories, let's listen to a song. The song is Nasty by Pixie Lott.
Come on, now just do it.
The song you just heard was Nasty by Pixie Lott. And coming back to MA Trash Can, we'll throw away your horrible memories or episodes here. So let's go to our next bit of trash, and it comes from Gabriella Arroyo from the USA. Let's see, she writes, I want to erase when I confess to a guy who I've liked for 3 years and he rejected me. Such a sad reality. I think only people who have similar experiences as me will be able to understand. Maybe you have a similar experience? I want to erase this memory, but I think it's going to be difficult. I also want to say I wish him the best and Happy New Year in 2015. And I also want to wish everyone Happy New Year. Aww. Do I have a similar experience? I do have a similar experience. There was a time where, it's a long time ago now, but I confessed to someone and it didn't work out well, you know. And the way that it feels, I think it's definitely everyone has an experience where they confessed and they, you know, it didn't work out. You know, that happens to a lot of people, but the way I think it is, it works for me at least, and the way it's worked for some of my friends is as time passes, it'll become a memory, and you know, now it might hurt, and for now it might feel like a big thing that's gonna leave a big scar, but hopefully over time it'll heal, and then you'll find another guy who you'll like, who, you know, he might be even better than this guy, and then you know, it'll work out maybe with this guy, you know. It's a new year, so it's time for new times. 2015, let's do it. But don't worry, Gabriella. For you, I'll erase your memory. And we can do it on the count of three. You ready? 1, 2, 3, delete. And it's gone. All right, you hear that? Now that memory's gone completely. And we've got a fresh start to 2015. So guys, if you have memories that you want to delete or mistakes that you want to erase, leave us your messages for MA Trash Can and let's talk about it together and comfort each other, alright? All you need to do is come visit us at www.arirangradio.com/musicaccess and leave me a message on our message board with the title MA Trash Can. All right, we'll come right back after a song for All About Music Quiz. The song is Perfect 2 by Auburn, requested by Clarie from Peru.
You're the smoke to my high, and you're the one I wanna marry. Cause you're the one for me, for me. And I'm the one for you, for you. You take the both of us, of us. And we're the perfect two. Yay. We're the perfect two. We're the perfect two. Baby, me and you. We're the perfect two.
All About Music and All About Quizzes, a great collaboration of music and quizzes, All About Music Quiz. quiz that progresses receives praise, but a quiz that is always the same gets ignored. All About Music Quiz is, to say the least, the most progressive quiz you'll ever come across. 5 different music quizzes from Monday through Friday. Get ready for the great music and have fun answering the prizes. And we have a special gift for one lucky listener who sends in the correct answer. Our AA Music Quiz present is Nicki Minaj's album The Pink Print, provided to us by Universal Music. So for our AA Music Quiz today, the format is guessing the group. I'm going to give you guys 3 hints for a certain group. Listen carefully to the 3 hints and try to guess what this group is. Are you ready? Reverb, please. Echo. All right, let's do it. All right, hint number 1. This group originally had 7 members, but right now only 3 are active in a unit group. What is the name of the unit group? Hint number 2. One group member's name starts with the letter that comes between K and M. Ooh, I almost said it. Hint number 3. This group's song is called Gasumi Tinda, My Heart Beats. All right, I'm gonna read them one more time. Hint number 1. The group originally had 7 members, but now only 3 are active in a unit group. And your question is, what is the name of the unit group? Hint number 2. One group member's name starts with the letter that comes between K and M. Hint number 3. This group's song is called Gasumi Tinda, My Heart Beats. If you know the answer, better get on it right now. So guys, if you know what the group is, write answer on your title and send us a message with the correct answer. We'll listen to a song and come back with the second hint for AA Music Quiz. The song is 처음엔 다 그래 by JJCC, requested by Venecita of Peru. 처음엔 다 그래. Alright guys, you just heard 처음엔 다 그래 by JJCC. And now we're back to a collaboration between music and quizzes, the AA Music Quiz. So the format for today is guessing the group. Before I give you the second hint, here's a brief review of the first hint, which is 3 parts. The first part, the group originally had 7 members, but now only 3 are active in a unit group. So what is the name of this unit group? Number 2, one group member's name starts with a letter that comes between K and M. Hint number 3, this group's song is called Gasumi Tinda, My Heart Beats. Okay, that was the first hint. Now we're going to listen to the second hint, which is a music hint. I'm going to let you guys hear a short part of the song from this group. If you haven't guessed already, this hint will really give the answer away. Ready? Alright, listen to the clip, please. Alright, so that was your hint. I don't know if that hint was easy, but I'm sure you have heard the song before. If you know the group, write answer on your title and send us a message with the correct answer. If you think you know the answer, come to the Music Access message board at www.arirangradio.com/musicaccess and leave us your answer with the title, Answer. So our AA Music Quiz present is Nicki Minaj's album The Pink Print, provided to us by Universal Music. So before we move on, let's listen to one more song. The song is 착해 빠졌어 by Soyu and Mad Clown, requested by Nur Hasina from Malaysia. The The song you just heard was 착해 빠졌어 by So You and Med Clown. I'm special DJ for Music Access, B.I.G.'s Benji, and it's time for message time. But before I go into my messages, during the break, I received word that my parents are listening and watching this broadcast right now. So I'm going to send a quick shout out to, hi, Mom and Dad. How are you having fun listening to the broadcast? Are you proud of your son? I hope you are. I'll do better. Shout out. All right. So our first message comes from Weijing 61 from Malaysia. And it says, happy new year. Hi, hi, DJ Benji. I see the video you beatbox with the lollipop. Oh, so funny. Haha. And do you think to have your own SNS? Hope you have a great day. Oh, so you saw the video of, I called it MC Satang. So like MC Candy. It's a video where I'm beatboxing with a lollipop. It's on our fan cafe. So, you know, if you want to go on our fan cafe and check it out, you have to register though. You know, do I want to have my own SNS? I do, but for now, I feel like as it is now, I wouldn't have time to really upload or do anything with it. So I think for now I'm good. All right. Thanks for your message. Our next message comes from Sime from Turkey. And it says, hi, I'm the sixth member, Sime of B.I.G. Ooh, I didn't even know there was a sixth member. 2014 was my year because I won K-pop dance contest and I have been invited to Korea, which is my dream country, with my family. I got the opportunity to meet with the B.I.G. interview in Korea and had a good holiday. I hope 2015 is referred to as a happy, lucky, and filled with new success year for myself and B.I.G. Benji, I want to ask a question to you. Do you have a dream that you want to happen in the new year? Well, first of all, Sime, congratulations on your winning of the K-pop dance contest. And in terms of what I want, a dream that I want to happen this year, I'm always talking about wanting to have a song that I produced and wrote on a B.I.G., you know, mini album, you know, album, whatever. Besides that, I think it would be really nice if B.I.G. could go on a show, like a variety show or a reality show or something, but just as a group, be able to show each other not only our group kind of skills, but also show each member's personality more. You know, that's a dream that I have, but you know, I have a whole year to do it, so we'll get on that soon. All right, thanks, Sime, for your message. Our next message comes from Tice from Brazil, and it says, hi Benji, today I rushed from class to see you since I met you at after school club end of the year special. I'm following all your activities, heart. You're amazing and I hope that this year you and B.I.G. have a great year. Even though I'm in Korea, I want you to know that Brazilian fans love you. Can you say, oi shi, hello shi, to my Brazilian friend that really likes you? Bye. So is oi like a casual way of saying hello, or is that like the term for hello? But I'm gonna say it. Oi, she, sup, B.I.G. Benji in the house. That was a shout out to Tice's Brazilian friend who I met at after school club end of the year, which was really fun, by the way. Guys, check it out on YouTube if you haven't seen it. All right, thank you for your message. And our next message comes from Irem from Korea, and it says, what's up, Benji? I'm the other admin of B.I.G. Turkey fan page, Irem. This is my first message to you, and I'm so excited. You look so swanky on the radio. Oops, sorry, you look so manly. Please say to Gummin, Irem's heart belongs to you. Heart, heart, heart. And finally, you already know that we love you all as B.I.G. Turkey admins. Aww. Except, I guess you're Gummin's fan. So, you know, I don't know why I'm reading this message. You know, no, I'm just kidding. Swanky, that is a term I have not seen in a long time. For those of you who don't know, swanky is, if as I remember, I could be wrong, but I think it's a term from used from way back, which means, you know, a cool guy, but I'm not sure. But that's how I would prefer to interpret it. Swanky. I am swanky. I am swanky. All right. So thank you for your message. Our next message comes from Ginny Ka from Canada, and it says, hello, Benji. I'm just from Calgary. It's a city in the province besides BC. Last time you mentioned that you visited Canada a lot. Any memorable stories worth sharing? I hope B.I.G. could come perform when there's a chance. That would be awesome. That would be awesome for us too. In terms of stories, you know, while my parents are listening, I might as well talk about it. When I was little in, you know, junior high and in elementary school, we visited Vancouver I remember like once a year, like we'd drive up there and we'd, you know, we'd eat Canadian food. You know, I never really got a chance to eat poutines at the time, but you know, we visited Vancouver and we had a lot of fun. You know, good family stories. But you know what? We'll save it for another time. Ooh, it's like a teaser. All right, thanks for your message, Jeannie. And our final message for this comes from Azelhui Alba Sandoval from Mexico. And it says, hi, Benji. I'm a new fan of you. I like how you play the violin. Saludos. All right. Thank you for becoming a new fan. I will become a better person in 2015. So look forward to that. Violin, you know, I keep saying it. Thank you, Mom and Dad, for teaching me how to play the violin, or starting me on violin, rather. You were amazing. And everyone who's listening, you know, send a shout out to my mom and dad because they were awesome enough to start me down that path. But, you know, now that I'm doing K-pop, you know, I got to work on the singing and the dancing. So it's a work in progress, but, you know, we can do it. All right. Thanks to everyone who sent in your messages for message time. Let's listen to a song before we come back with more. The song is Life is Good by Epic High featuring Park Jae-beom. That's right, Life is Good. And that is also the song we just heard, Life is Good by Epic High featuring Park Jae-beom. All right, guys, we're going to share a couple more messages before we move on. The first message is from Tony from the Philippines, and it says, hello, Benji, you mentioned that you cook. Is there a particular dish that you love to make? And do you still cook from time to time? A dish that I cooked at home for my parents, you know, they'd go to work and I'd come back earlier from school, so sometimes I'd make them dinner. And one thing that I used to make was like a fried rice. You know, that was my thing. Fried rice with like an egg soup on the side, which is actually one of my dad's recipes, which is actually a recipe he learned from my grandma. So, you know, there's that. For now, I don't have a lot of time to cook. So, you know, I cook whenever I can, but it's hard to find time. And, you know, the worst part about cooking, the dishwashing, you know, dishwashing is I don't like dishwashing. So that's why I don't cook as much anymore, but it's mostly a time thing. All right, and the next message comes from Danielle from Australia, and it says, hello, Benji, how's your day been? Enjoying the cold Seoul weather? Because I'm enjoying the hot Australian 37-degree weather. You know, you have 37-degree weather, but you know what? Our weather is super cool. So you know what? You can keep your hot weather. No, I'm just kidding. No, but it is, the weather in Seoul right now is actually quite cold. But, you know, I'm putting on my warm clothes. You know, I'm dressing in layers. I was wearing a jacket at the start of today's broadcast, and then I took it off because this studio right here is actually really warm. So, you know, don't worry about me. For everyone who's listening in Korea, remember to dress warm. And for everyone who's listening in Australia, don't forget to dress down. All right, all right. So the song that we just heard is Life is Good, and it's almost time to wrap up the first hour. And remember, in the second hour, we have Crazy No joining us for our Friday Corner Dancing in the Club MA. This week's topic is things I've never done before in my life. So think about some things that you've wanted to try but were never able to do before, and share it with us by writing Club MA on your title before sending it on a message. All right, guys. So, are you ready for Dancing in the Club? It's my first time meeting Crazy Now, so I'm also excited. You know, it is my last guest of the week. So we're going to try to make this final guest of the week as exciting as possible by turning up at Music Access. So don't go away. We'll be right back after this song, Can't Remember to Forget by Shakira featuring Rihanna. Music Access. What's up, guys? Welcome to the second hour of the Friday edition of Music Access. I'm Benji from BIG, filling in for Aaron here on Music Access. In the second hour today, Crazy No will be joining us in the studio with Dancing in the Club MA. This week's topic is things I've never done before in my life. Think about some things that you've wanted to try but were never able to do before and share it with us. Just write Club MA on your title before sending your messages to us. Here's how you can listen and participate. You can download the Arirang Radio or TuneIn Radio application on your smartphones, and you can also send us messages through the app using the comment function. You can also listen to us by visiting our website www.arirangradio.com/musicaccess and leave your messages there on our message board. You can also see our broadcast in real time! Woo! Another way you can tune in is through terrestrial DMB, but this is only available for our listeners living on Jeju Island. The frequencies are 88.7 for Jeju City, 88.1 for Seogwipo, and 101.9 for Daejeon. Alright, after listening to a song, we'll come right back with Crazy No for Dancing in the Club MA. The song is Lunatic by Crazy No. On Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. So now it's Friday and it's time for a well-deserved break. If you worked hard this week, raise your hands in the air.
Shake it. We're in all the stress from the week with Dancing in the Club MA.
So, well, what's up, Crazy No? It's our first time meeting, right?
Yeah.
You know, happy to meet you. I am B.I.G.'s Benji.
Whoa. Look, I actually haven't heard of that group yet.
We actually just debuted recently, about 6 months ago, July of last year.
Right.
So, you know, first things first, Happy New Year!
Woo!
Happy New Year! Turn up! All right, so I heard that you love partying and hanging out with people. So much that you only got 2 hours of sleep on Christmas Eve.
Yes, I did. I had 2 hours of sleep for like 2 days.
Wow.
During Christmas. Yep. And I was here right after Christmas.
Uh-huh.
So I was like half asleep on the radio.
It is January 2nd today.
Mm-hmm.
So if you only got 2 hours of Christmas Eve.
Yep.
Your New Year's Day. Your New Year's Eve, you didn't sleep, right?
I didn't sleep.
You didn't sleep at all. At all. Did you, you know, pop bottles?
Actually, I was at Busan.
Busan?
At my last day of 2014.
Uh-huh.
And I was doing the countdown on Gwanghwanli.
Wow. Gwanghwanli,
yeah. There was this club called something like Fix.
Uh-huh.
Something like Fix. Yeah, and I was there doing the countdown with all the people that I know. Yeah, so
wow, that
was pretty good.
Fun.
It was pretty good.
So did you make a wish then when the countdown was going on?
I wish everybody that I know would be healthy, because I had a lot of people that were injured and stuff like during 2014. So I think everyone should be healthy, you know.
That's good.
Mm-hmm.
So you were there for like the countdown.
Yep.
So there was a survey done on Koreans recently,
mm-hmm.
and they were asked about what they wished for on New Year's Day. Do you know what the number one wish was?
Diet?
Diet. I bet that's something a lot of people wish for.
Yeah.
But it was, I wish I can make a lot of money. And for students, college students especially, I wish I could get a job.
Job?
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
So do you have a upcoming wish for this year?
Actually I was trying to get like fit.
Buff.
Yeah, so but I don't like being in the gym for a long time. So I was planning for doing rock climbing.
Rock climbing?
Yeah, so I could do both stuff, you know, hang around with friends and like exercise.
Hardcore.
At the same time. Yeah, so
hecka hardcore rock climbing.
Rock climbing.
That's really intense.
Mm.
That's really impressive.
Have you ever tried rock climbing before?
I have never tried rock climbing. Like, you know the walls they have at gyms sometimes with like the holds and stuff?
I've tried that,
but that itself was hard. So I can't even imagine what it's like to, go real.
I'm not sure if there's like a natural rock climbing place in Korea, but still, I'm trying to find out if there's any, you know.
Good luck on that, bro.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so a lot of people make New Year's resolutions and plans at the start, but, you know, if you follow what everyone else is doing, then you end up not being able to keep up with these things sometimes.
Yes.
So today's topic that we picked out is things I've never tried before.
Whoa.
So think about things that you've wanted to do but were unable to, and pick the ones that you really want to try this year. For our Music Access family members, keep on sending your messages, and we'll talk about the things that we want to try this year for now. First, what is something... Oh, man, this club music is so intense. So, what is something that you wanted to try but couldn't or didn't have a chance to? Okay, so have you ever worked at a regular company or office before?
No.
Okay.
Yep.
So then, have you ever wanted to be like, for example, a model?
Model? No, I'm too short for a model.
So, how about a doctor?
Oh, actually, I've studied psychology in high school, so maybe some kind of, they don't call a doctor like in Australia, but they do in Korea, right?
Uh-huh.
Like 정신과, so maybe, yeah, I could have done something like that if I had the chance.
Just realized I never asked. So you're from Australia?
Yeah.
So then, have you ever, no, this is gonna be so bad.
Yeah.
Kangaroos.
Kangaroos, yeah.
Have you ever, like, I don't know, I saw a video where, like, a kangaroo was fighting another kangaroo in the street.
Whoa. Okay. they don't actually box. I heard that they have a really good kick.
They have a good kick?
Back kick or something. Uh-huh. Yeah, they have, like, for like 7 years now, so it's quite a long time.
Nice.
And yeah, I think that's all I've did. Well, how about you?
I've never really done any like at a convenience store or anything like that.
Mm-hmm.
But when I used to do violin,
okay.
So I used to do violin very seriously. So I'd go out and, you know, do gigs and stuff like that.
Gigs?
Like weddings. Weddings are you know, sub in for someone at a concert.
Mm-hmm.
So that for me was kind of a part-time job, but that was very random. It was like someone randomly calls up and you're like, yo, so I gotta go to a concert, but I can't go there, so can you sub in for me? Stuff like that.
Okay.
But you know, it was fun. So then, you know, it's a dangerous topic, but I'm gonna plant the mine. So what about dating?
Dating.
Have you ever had a long distance? Oh, wow.
Mm.
So your first girlfriend was also a long-distance relationship.
No, actually, we were together, and then she had to move back. Didn't work out that good. 4 months after she left,
I think.
Mm. Yeah.
And then
it's really hard, you know.
I can imagine.
Mm-hmm.
So then what about dating someone a lot older or younger? It's like I'm interviewing you for, like, a dating profile right now.
Yeah. 7... up, 6 down.
6 down? 7 up, 6 down.
Yep. So
currently you are 28.
Yeah, but she wasn't 35 then. I mean, I was like,
oh,
younger.
Oh, yeah, age-wise.
Yeah. So it's like 7 years older and 6 years younger.
Mm.
I think I've dated before. Okay. All right. I'll ask you later.
No, go ahead. Ask me.
Yeah. You're like 24 now, right?
Yeah. I'm turning 24, Korean age this year.
Mm, so, what was your like longest range? I mean, highest range, maybe, should I say?
Like the longest relationship I've had, or like in terms of like long distance.
I was thinking.
I've never had a long distance relationship.
What about age? Like the
oh,
highest,
like for my age going up and down.
Mm.
I think up like 6.
Whoa, 6.
I don't know. I've never thought about that. I'll be honest. I've never, because for me right now, you know, it's not just because I'm an idol. It's not just because I'm an idol. But for now, I'm really focused on music. Because you mentioned that you make music.
Mm-hmm,
and
right.
I'm, you know, I didn't come from, you know, a contemporary music background.
Mm.
I came from a classical music background.
Oh, yeah.
But coming into K-pop, I acquired a lot of interest for, you know, music production and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm really focused on the music right now. And especially because, you know, I don't know any girls or any guys for that matter in Korea. Except for the guests that I'm meeting this week.
Woo!
Music Access!
Who's that?
So that's like, for example, on Monday I met Tasha. Tuesday I met Jane. Wednesday I met Jimin. Yesterday I met Gihun.
Okay. I'm sorry that you met Jane. Jane.
You're sorry. Oh, is that like a backstory?
Yeah. Yeah. Mm. Okay.
Okay. So then, are you a stingy lover?
What do you mean by that? I don't actually get that. Stingy lover?
I think that's like, are you a thrifty spender when it comes to dating?
No, I actually make plans with my girlfriend how to spend money.
Oh, wow.
Depending on the income for her and mine. So, yeah.
Mm. Oh, wow. That's like... Yeah. That's the first time I've heard of something like that for me. You know.
Actually, I've tried like a lot of things. Like we made a couple, what do you call it?
A bank account.
Yeah, bank account. Yes. Yeah, yeah. So, we both put money in, uh-huh. and then we just use one card uh-huh. like whenever we do something. So,
oh, yeah.
I've tried a lot of stuff, but I don't think it really works that much.
Mm-hmm.
First, it's like it's in a good way.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we meant to do something really good, but. Mm-hmm. It doesn't like turn out that good later on, because one of us is gonna use more money. Well, yeah.
So for anyone interested in that idea, mm-hmm. let that be a lesson. You know, pay attention to lessons.
Yep.
And learn. Woo. All right. So I'm sorry. This is kind of my fault, but we kind of got off topic.
Mm.
So back to things about things we've never done.
Mm-hmm.
So what about foods? When it comes to food.
Food.
Mm-hmm. So you strike me as someone who has had their experience of both Korean food and Australian food.
Yeah,
fair share.
There's no such as Australian food actually.
Marmite, or Vegemite. I'm sorry.
Vegemite. Not one of my favorites. Pass on that. Actually, in Australia, you can like have a lot of food because it's like multicultural.
Uh-huh,
so
uh-huh.
you can try. Like Italian, like as in real Italian, not fusion, you know, some countries. So I like Italian the best and Japanese food.
Japanese food.
Japanese food?
I like all food. So, you know, I'm actually trying to, you know, work out a little bit more because, you know, I gained a little weight over the Christmas time. But, mm-hmm. you know, I don't really discriminate when it comes to food.
Okay.
Except there's one food that I don't think I'll ever be able to try.
What's that?
It's called hongo in Korean.
Ah,
it's called
kwemoko.
She's like, he's a mighty weeper. No, I'm just so interested, but I feel like I'll never be able to eat it because
I'm not gonna eat it too.
For those of you listening who are who don't know what hongo is, it's a kind of fermented fish, right?
Yeah,
it's a fermented fish, but it has a very very strong aroma and a very very strong flavor that some people that have had it described it similar to paint thinner.
Paint
thinner, like the smell.
Mm.
So, you know, that's something that I'm not gonna say I'll never try.
Yep.
But I've never tried it yet. You know, I've tried the live octopus. You know, chicken feet. It's really good, by the way.
What did you like the chicken feet?
I love the chicken feet.
I never try that.
Really?
Because
it's so good.
The visual actually like reminds me.
Of
the like live chicken. So I couldn't.
Sort of, no, I totally know what that is. When I first saw it, I was like, ooh.
Yeah.
And then I took a bite. I was like, okay, I'm going to try it though.
Mm.
And it's really good.
Mm.
So then, besides food, mm-hmm. is there something that you think I will never be able to try? Or you've never had the opportunity to try that you would like to try?
Some of these extreme sports.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I had the chance in Australia to do all these flying stuff, you know, mm-hmm. jumping off and planes, things like that. But if I could go back to Australia, just for fun,
mm-hmm.
I think I'm gonna try now, because then I was sort of afraid, you know, mm-hmm. that I could sort of die.
Oh, you know, death is something, you know, it's a little serious, you know, you can't recover from it.
Yeah.
So, you know, for example, for me, I was always curious, but I don't think I'll never ever try it.
Mm-hmm.
Squirrel jumping.
What's squirrel jumping?
I don't know if it's called squirrel jumping. It's where they have the wingsuit. Like this.
Ah.
You know what I'm talking about?
Mm.
It's like they have a wingsuit and then they jump from places and then they kind of maneuver through the air like a...
Yeah, yeah. It's like a... Glider. Yeah, it's like a bat, right?
Like a bat. It's like a bat suit kind of thing.
Mm.
It's a bat. Batman's bat suit is way cooler. Mm. So, we have talked about a lot of things we've never tried.
Mm-hmm.
But if there's something that you guys, the listeners, have never tried, let us know. Today's Dancing in the Club MA topic is things I've never done before in my life. So think about some things that you've wanted to try, but were never able to do before, and share it with us. Just write Club MA on your title before sending your messages to us. Now, we are going to listen to a song, and then we'll come back and take a look at your messages. The song is Feel This Moment by Pitbull featuring Christina Aguilera.
Yes, for money.
Just wanna feel this moment.
Our Friday corner, dancing in the club, and May, we're here in the studio with Crazy No. Yeah, we're back. So let's take a look at the things our MA family members have never tried before. Starting with the first one. Would you like to read the first one?
Where is this?
Kimberly from the USA.
Yep. Something I really want to do in 2015 is to visit Namsan.
Woo.
And eat more traditional food, Korean food.
Yeah.
Okay, I've only visited Korea once, but I didn't get to visit all the famous tourist destinations yet. So I ate really amazing Korean food also, but I didn't get to try out everything since I was only in Korea for a few days.
Oh.
I really want to visit again this year. And meet Benji too.
Yeah.
Woo.
I am Benji. Hear me roar.
Benji!
Oh, visit Namsan. Have you visited Namsan Tower?
Namsan, yeah.
I did too.
Mm.
It's a nice place to visit. They have these things where like they show you how far a city is. It's like, this city is this many kilometers away, this city is this many kilometers away, which is really interesting.
Mm. So who did you go with?
Just a friend.
Oh, with friends. A friend. Yeah. Okay.
Mm. And traditional Korean food. Traditional Korean food.
Bulgogi kimchi.
Oh, yeah. That's in our debut song, actually.
Oh, really?
Kimchi, jokkabi, bulgogi, samgyeopsal is so tasty.
All right, I gotta listen to that song. It's kind of my style.
We should remake it to a club remix.
Yep.
Mm. All right, Kimberly, nice. We get you. All right, our next message comes from Mary Rose Detke from the USA. She says, skydiving.
Mm.
My sister is third in USA freestyle skydiving.
Whoa.
Shout out to Mary Rose's sister for being third in the USA first freestyle skydiving. But I'm not 18 tier, but when I can, I will skydive with her.
Oh,
ooh, wow. Mary Rose.
So there's an age limit?
I guess maybe there's an age restriction, I guess.
Okay.
I guess maybe it's because like you need to be fully developed as, you know, an adult.
Mm.
Just to, you know, make sure there's no complications, I guess.
Right.
You know. Wait, so you're going to try skydiving when you go back to Australia?
Yeah, I'm thinking.
Skydiving and then like doing the flips in the air while you do it.
I think you need a lot of training to do that, right? But I'm gonna try. I'll try.
You should do it. You should take a video and send it over here.
Yeah.
And we go post it up. All right. So our next message comes from Daphne from the USA.
Mm-hmm.
And it says, I have never gone to Korea before. Going to Korea is on my bucket list. So this year in 2015, I'm planning to study abroad there since I am a college student.
Oh.
Ooh, so you've never come to Korea before. But you are a college student, so I will tell you, you will have a good time here. I guarantee that.
You should probably get like a friend before you come. So don't try to go like around visiting all the like tourist destinations, but the places like in between.
Yeah.
The real fun places that only the Korean people know.
The real fun places?
Yeah, that's not on the tourist book list.
Like the wink fun places?
Yeah, so you shouldn't be, you know, all over the place. You should be like in some hot places.
But it's, you think it's good to come with someone?
Yeah, it is.
Because two is always better than one.
Yep.
And you can definitely have a fun time with two people.
Yeah.
All right. So the next one, would you like to read it?
Catherine from USA.
Woo.
Okay, I don't have much exercise since I work in a pharmacy, so I want to get out and do more activities.
Yeah.
Maybe I'll make use of the open spaces where I live and take up archery and horseback riding again.
Again?
So she used to do archery
and horseback riding.
Okay, ooh. So maybe go to the shooting range.
Wow.
As well.
Wow.
Okay, okay. And she says she's not active, so. Right, okay. I've never been able to use the range before, so it might be fun.
Wow. So definitely, this is. She's pretty active.
You know, she's very active.
She may not have been. She may not be active now since she works in a pharmacy.
Mm.
But definitely for sure, she used to be active.
Mm.
Archback horse riding, shooting range. Oh no, she's never been to the range before.
Okay.
But I always wanted to go to a shooting range and just try it out.
Mm.
You know, on YouTube they have those videos of people shooting like really crazy guns. You know, I don't condone gun violence, mm-hmm. and I don't really like shooting anything. You know, except maybe the arcade when you shoot the little lasers at the targets. But right. You know, I think it'll be heck of fun.
Mm.
All right.
Archery. Okay.
Archery. That's interesting. All right. So our next message comes from Aura from Canada, and it says, "Although I've lived in Canada for 8 years or so, I've never been snowboarding. I'm a little scared, lol. But it looks cool. Have you been snowboarding before?"
No.
No. I ski. I
ski,
actually.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
All right. Because I've Australia is not. Not a skiing country.
Oh, yeah.
They don't have snow.
That's true.
Yeah, so when I came to Korea, like, when I went to the skiing place with my friends,
mm-hmm.
I figured out that I can't, you know, do any balance sports.
Ah.
I'm out of balance.
Out of balance. But no. In Australia, it's really hot, right?
Right.
So you might not snow ski, but you could water ski, right?
Yeah, but I am, as I said, out of balance.
The balance is not as strong as, you know, your other talents. We'll put it in a good light.
Yeah.
You know, but it's okay. We can learn. All right, our next one comes from Gabriela Arroyo from the USA, and it says, "I have always wanted to skydive, but during a sunset.
Ooh.
It would be wonderful seeing the view, and I would also like to try Korean food, which, by coincidence, I'm going to try next week." Ooh.
Oh, where?
I don't know.
Okay.
I don't know.
In Korea or in US?
I'm assuming the US.
Mm.
Or I don't know. I think if she was going to come to the Korea, she would have said something about coming
to
Korea. Skydive during a sunset. That might be romantic.
Oh.
You know what? I bet no one's never done.
What?
Propose while you skydive during a sunset.
Pose?
Propose.
Oh.
Like a marriage proposal.
Okay.
So like the wind's brushing past your hair and you're like, and then you go, "Hey, will you marry me?" "What? I can't hear you. Will you marry me?" Don't you think that would be interesting?
Yeah.
Hello?
Oh, yeah. Are you going to try that when you're going to propose someone? Is that how you...
You know, it's an idea.
Okay.
I'll put it in my idea bank.
Okay.
What about you? What were you going to say?
How am I gonna propose?
Yeah, how are you gonna propose?
I heard that girls don't like being watched at when they get proposed.
I heard that too.
They don't want to be in public or they don't want to be in like between friends. They just want to be, you know,
one-on-one.
Yeah, one-on-one. So probably somewhere quiet and, you know, private.
I mean, the sky is very private.
Oh.
The sky's private. And if you put on your headphones, you can't hear anything. You can read the lips, you know. Text it while you're driving.
Okay, he's not letting go of that. He's not letting go of that idea. Okay.
So, you know, guys, if you're going to get married, do it while skydiving.
Yeah.
All right, so let's listen to a song before we move on. The song is Skip to the Bit by Club de Balugas.
It's like that. Let it go, boy.
Skip to the bit. Let your backbone slip. Take a little trip. When you skip to the bit, don't be so hip. Take this little tip. Let your spirit rip. When you skip to the bit.
you skip to the bip? Our Friday corner, dancing in the club MA. We're here in the studio with Crazy No. Hello, let's continue to take a look at the things our MA family members have never tried before. Starting with Aura from Canada. She says, one thing I want to do is get a different hairstyle that I wouldn't do before. For example, dyeing my hair a crazy color. Do you guys want to try a hairstyle out?
Woo! Hairstyle. What have you been, like, dark hair or, like all over the place?
I've been mostly dark, sometimes light.
Mm.
But for me, I want to try, you know what they call, I call it the Macklemore.
Macklemore?
You know the rapper Macklemore?
Yeah.
You know, I'm gonna make some cash. Mm. He shaved the sides of his head, leave the top on. I forget what it's called in English, that's why I'm calling it the Macklemore.
What do you call that?
The Macklemore?
Double cut, I mean, with a two block?
Two block? I don't know, but like, you know what I'm talking about? And then like straight up.
Yeah.
But like divide it. So one goes left and one goes right.
Yeah, I think Taeyang does that.
Yeah, it's very similar. Yeah. What about you?
Actually, when I was in high school, I dyed a lot of times in many different colors before. Like I tried red and black, blonde and purple, blue.
Wow.
Because I usually went to this ice cream shop, saw the ice cream, and then got the motivation from the ice cream.
Wow.
So if it was like a blueberry but vanilla ice cream, I tried that like in my head, like bleached it out with a blonde, and then put bleach purple, and then squirrel it up like ice cream.
So you were the ice cream man.
Yeah,
literally.
I was like, my head used to look like an ice cream cone.
Oh wow.
Mm, yeah.
That's stylish.
Yeah, it was quite strange and good.
No wonder then. You're known as Crazy No.
Yeah. That's 10 years ago.
10 years ago. All right. Yeah. So our next one comes from Danielle from Australia. Ooh.
Danielle.
Australia. Mm. Hello, Benji and Crazy No. Something that I have never done before but really want to is fly in a plane and travel. I've never been out of the country, let alone the state of Victoria. Let's hope that can happen soon. There's so many people I need to meet all around the world, including you.
Danielle. She's really familiar. She sends us like a lot of messages every week. Yeah. You should come to Korea.
Come to Korea.
Mm. Korea, or like maybe Phuket. I always like say Phuket because I had a really good time at Phuket before on my vacation, and it's somewhere good to go flying. You know.
Word.
Wherever it is, hey.
Flying wherever you want.
Mm-hmm.
Korea or Phuket.
Hmm.
Let's do it, Danielle.
Yeah.
I believe in you, girl. You can do it. All right. Our next one comes from Maith Gonzalez from Peru. Says, I really like music, so one of the things I've always wanted to try is play an instrument. One of my favorite instruments is violin, so I once tried to play it, but I was not very good. Now I am learning to play the piano, but I still love how the violin sounds. Benji, I envy you because you play it beautifully. Is it hard to play the violin? Ooh, this is a question for me. When I started, it was difficult, but definitely now it's something that's become ingrained into my personality and like my body, so to speak. So it's a very natural thing now.
Mm.
But you know, anyone listening, pick up an instrument. I recommend it. You know, you recommend it as well?
Yep.
Picking up an
anything,
instrument.
Anything, you know, like triangles would be good.
Triangles. Like the brrrr ring.
No, just ding, 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 ding. You know what that is?
Yeah.
Do you know what it is?
Yeah.
Ding, 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 ding. I mean, if it's too hard to play like a musical instrument, it's always too good, you know, like drums or triangles, castanets.
Mm-hmm.
They're still instruments. So.
On a side note, girls who learn instruments, guys like it, and guys, girls love guys who do instruments.
Oh.
I think it goes for vice versa. Am I right?
Yep. That's why I play the piano. That's the only reason I play the piano.
All right. That's why he plays the piano.
Mm-hmm.
All right, guys. So I'm going to have to wrap it up. Thank you, everyone, for sending us your messages.
Yeah.
So next week, if there's something that you wanted to do but you've never done, something similar.
You can send us messages next week. We'll do something similar like from this week, which is the topic might be something like things that you never done but you want to try, like something that if you were shy or you had all these problems to do something because everyone like you feel everyone's looking at you,
mm-hmm.
you can try all those stuff at MA next week.
So hook us up with those messages.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so how was it today? Did you feel the vibe?
Too much, yeah, but it was really good. You know, I actually... Okay, all right. Usually I'm the crazy guy. I got this other crazy guy in the studio, guys.
Oh, yeah.
If you can see this on the video, I mean, what do you call it?
The video screen?
Yeah.
Camera?
Yes. I hope you guys could see you next week. What he's doing during radio. I've never seen these things before. Right.
You know, maybe it's because you just got over the New Year's partying.
Yeah.
So I've he's been recovering. So you're recovering. Yeah. So you'll be back on Friday. Next
yeah.
week, and we's gonna party it up.
And so I'm gonna be dancing too.
True that. So you have any more parties to attend this weekend?
Not this weekend. It's
not this weekend. You have to retire.
Yep.
All right, man. So next week, recover.
Yeah.
I will see you then.
Right.
So sending Crazy No out. Here is a song. We're all just down to Get Lucky by Daft Punk featuring Pharrell Williams.
Get lucky.
Bye.
Get lucky. Get
And we are back with that song was Get Lucky by Daft Punk featuring Pharrell Williams. And it's now time to reveal the answer for AA Music Quiz from the first hour. What is the answer? The answer is Infinite F. A lot of people sent us the right answer, but we picked just one. And our lucky winner is Kenny So from Singapore. Congratulations. Please send us a message with your name, address, phone number, the date you were chosen, and email address on our message board under the title Winner. Our AA Music Quiz present is Nicki Minaj's album, The Pink Print, provided to us by Universal Music. And before we go, let's share some more messages sent in to us by our listeners with Message Time. The first message comes from Satu from Finland. Hi, Benji. How are you? I'm sorry I missed the first hour of MA. I was just too sleepy and the warm blankets had trapped me to the bed. But now I'm here listening. Are you still nervous? It's been almost a week already and I think you're getting quite used to being a DJ. You're doing a great job and I hope you have a nice day. Aw, thank you. What's up, Satu? Hope you're listening. I'm not really nervous anymore. I'm very comfortable now. And this time I had with Crazy Note just really amped up the energy. You know, he's a great guy. All right, so thank you for your message. Our next message comes from Darcy Ann from the USA. It says, Benji, it was very sweet of you to say what you did for your parents. Nice that the recipe is handed down from the generations. I hope you get more time to do some more cooking as it seemed like you enjoy doing that. The best thing to do while cooking is to get a garbage bowl, so a bowl you can use to put in the scraps of garbage as you cook. As you are working, do some cleanup when you can, rather than wait until you're finished and are stuck with too much to clean up. You are a very sweet guy, and I am very glad you came here to help out. Oh, thank you. You know, the garbage bowl idea, I actually did that before, and then I still ended up cleaning all of it at the very end. I think there must be a problem with the way I work. Ugh. But thank you, Darcy Ann, for your idea and your message. Our next message comes from myself from the Philippines, and it says, Hello, Benji. Happy New Year. I just want to say thank you for wishing me a belated happy birthday the other day and the birthday rap. It's so awesome. I was giggling while listening to you. You are so sweet. Again, thank you and 사랑해. Aww. 사랑해. I'm sending your heart to the camera. Hope you're watching. All right. Thanks for your message. And our final message for this session comes from Mara from the USA. And it's a shout out to my parents. It says, Hi, Benji's mom and dad. Benji is awesome and you've done a wonderful job raising a great son. I see great things for him in the future. Oh, thank you, Mara, for your message. Mom and dad, see you raised a good son. Be proud of it. That was so attacking. All right, thank you to everyone who sent in your messages during message time. And let's listen to a song that was requested by our listener now. The song is 준비됐나요 by the one and only B.I.G. requested by Heather Folsom from the USA, Kimberly from the USA, and Sienna Tridano from the Philippines.
Hey, girl. Are you ready? Right now.
준비됐나요
Let go.
비는 넘보다 더 빨리 비는 놈이 나야 가지고 싶은 건 다 가져다 채워둘 준비 다 됐어
나 지금 쓸받았어 이제 돌이킬 수 없어 너 때문에 난리 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 났어 난 내 손바닥 뒤에 도망갈 수 없어 넌 이제 내 여자야 벗어날 수 없어
It was a great first week, but don't worry because we have one more week together. Our last song for today is Madness by Muse. I am Benji of BIG, and I will be back tomorrow. See y'all.